Hello friends, welcome back. So here is our next hint. How do we find the area of a composite figure? What's a composite figure? A composite figure is anytime you have like a big shape that you can break into independent shapes, right? Independent figures. So here we have this craziness, but it's a triangle, it's a rectangle, and then a half circle. Well, that's fine, right? So cool. So here we go. Formulas. Let's think about this. Formulas. How do we find the area of a circle? Area equals pi r squared. So 3.14 times the radius squared. Rectangle. Area is base times height or length times width. Either way. So you have the base and the height or the length and the width. It doesn't matter. You can call it. Those terms are interchangeable. And then a triangle. Area is half of base times height. Or base times height divided by 2. So we'll get into that. I just took that shape and I broke it up. So now we have the rectangle, the triangle, and the half circle. So let's look at it. Rectangle, base times height. Well, let's do that. 15 times 5 is what? 5 times 5 is 25. 2, 5 times 1 is 5, plus 2 is 7, 75. Okay, so 75 centimeters, and it's squared because it's two-dimensional. Cubed is for three dimensions, volume. Squared is area. And now a triangle, think about this. Base times height gave us a quadrilateral. So if we did a base times height, wouldn't we end up with a rectangle? Yeah, but we don't want that. We only want the triangle, so that's half of base times height. So 5.5 times 4. 5 times 4 is 20, okay? 5 times 4 is 20 plus 2. Is 22, and there's one decimal in the problem, so you know it's not 220, it's 22. So that would be the entire square. Now we have to divide that by 2. So 22 divided by 2 is 2 goes into 2 one time, 2 goes into 2 one time. So our answer is 11. So this is 11 centimeters squared. Okay, now we're getting into, I'm gonna just clear all this work. There's a lot to do here, a lot of math. What is here's our diameter all the way across the circle, moving through the center point. So let's find the radius, right? So our radius is 5.5 divided by 2, because it's half of the diameter. 2 goes into 5, 2 times, right? So 2 times 2 is 4, 1, drop the 5, okay? Oh, we have a decimal in the dividend, so let's raise it to the quotient. 2 times 7 is 14. Well, 15 minus 14 is 1, and then we can add zeros because it's to the right of a decimal. You can add as many zeros as you want to the right of a decimal. So we'll drop that 0. 2 goes into 10, 5 times. So our radius equals 2.75. Okay, we're good. We got that. Now, we want to multiply the radius. We have to square. Remember, please excuse my dear Aunt Sally. Exponents first. So what's radius squared? Okay, radius is 2.75 times 2.75. Yeesh, this is going to be some math, right? And you don't have a calculator always, so we'll just do it. We can just do it. 5 times 5, 25, 2, 35, 37, 3, 10, 13. Okay, we have to add a 0. 7 times 5 is 35. 7 times 7, plus 3, right? 7 times 7 is 49, plus 3 is 52. Okay, so we're going to change that to 5. 7 times 2 is 14, plus 5 is 19. Then we add 2 zeros. Ha! 2 times 5 is 10. Carry over the 1. 2 times 7 is 14, plus 1 is 15. Okay. 15, now it's got to be a 1, 8 now. 2 times 2 is 4, plus 1 is 5. Boom. So 5. 7 and 5 is 12. Carry my 1. 1 plus 3 is 4, plus 2 is 6. 1 plus 9 is 10, plus 5 is 15. 7. Woo! Now look, we have 1, 2, 3, 4 decimals. 4 decimals in the problem, so 1, 2, 3, 4. 7.56. That's our answer, 7.56. Okay, so now, depending on how much you're rounding, we could just say 7.6. Okay, so let's say that. 7.6 is our r squared is 7.6. 7.6. So now we have to times 7.6 times pi. Pi, we know, is 3.14. So 3.14. 6 times 4 is 24. 6 times 1 is 6 plus 2 is 8. 6 times 3 is 18. Start with our 0. 7 times 4 is 28. 2, 7 times 1, 7 plus 2 is 9. 7 times 3 is 21. 4, 16, 9 plus 9 is 18. 1 plus 1 plus 1 is 3. 2, and there's 3, 1, 2, 3 decimals. There's 3 decimals in the problem. So 1, 2, 3. Ah. Okay. Boom. That is area of a circle. This problem is so full of tricks because you have the triangle, which is you get half of that rectangle, half of the quadrilateral, and this is a half circle. So we cannot stop at 23.864. So let's divide, let's just say it's 23.9, because we're rounding to the first tenth place, right? Divided by 2, because it's a half circle, it's a half, right? Half. 2 goes into 2 one time, 2 goes into 3 one time. There's a decimal, so, right? So there's a remainder of 1. 2 goes into 19 and 9 times, because 18, right? So check it out. Boom. We have our answer here. 10 centimeters, we got it. 75 centimeters, we got it. 11.87 centimeters. 96, we add all those together, the area of our composite figure is 96.87 centimeters squared. Good luck. Let me know what you think. We'll see you next time.